Good girl. Come on, here.
We'll focus this session on leash for the most part. I know it sounds like you've been having some trouble with Miss Lucy pulling, so we want to address that. You can see here, she's really doing fantastic. Good girl. Heel. Total loose leash walking. A couple things for you to keep in mind. Sit. Good. This is your power steering, right? She is a extremely sturdy dog. You can't be afraid to control her with the lead. Someone's always in control. Either you're in control of the dog or the dog's in control of you. So when we're working on our heel work and we're out for a walk or whatever, this is your power steering. If she starts to get out away from you or behind you, just a little tug. A little tug in the direction you want her to go. Heel. Good. If she's pulling, a little tug back. Heel. Good. Good girl. You kind of have to show her who's the boss and who's in charge. You have to be willing to do that. We never want to give a command that we can't enforce or that we're not willing to enforce. If she's pulling and we don't correct it and fix it, she's going to continue to pull. And I will tell you too, a little tip. Dogs will continue to pull against pressure. So what I mean by that, if she's pulling and I've got constant pressure on the lead, she's going to continue to pull against that versus having some slack in the lead and just giving her a little pop with the lead. Pop. Good girl. Of course, we're auto-sitting. She sits when I stop, pops her bottom down. Good girl. And she always expects some loving, which is fine. She's not nipping at me or licking or biting at my hand at all. So, sit. Good girl. What a good girl. Good girl. Heel. I like doing a figure eight drill to work on our leash work. Because dogs will have a natural tendency when I do an outside turn to keep going that way. So boom, just a little pop, line her back up. And then when we do an inside turn, sometimes they'll walk over in front of you and about trip you. We don't want that. We want them feeling that and them getting way to you as you start to turn. So they're not, it's not a trip hazard. They should match your gait. So if you're walking faster, they should walk faster. If you're walking slower, they should walk slower. Stop. They should sit. Good girl. That's a good girl. That's a good girl. She is wearing e-collar right now. I don't even have the remote. There's been zero e-collar corrections. It's all the lead, right? Just gotta show her you're in control. You know, when we're on a walk, it's not about sniffing every blade or after peeing on every bush. It's we're focused. She's focused on me. She's paying attention for the next command. If I stop, sit. Good girl. Good girl. Feel. I start. She starts. And this is all nonverbal too. She's programmed. So we'll do it nonverbal. She has a tendency to want to stop in front of you. I do not like that. So we're going to work on cleaning that up some. But that'll be something too for you that you'll want to hold her accountable to when she gets home. Sit. Sit here. Heel. Good. You notice I'm using my knee. You may or may not want to do that, but I'm using my knee to get her lined up. Consistency over time equals results. So the goal there is that if she does it enough, she'll know what's expected. She'll go right in the line. Heel. Sit. Good. Good girl. Sit. 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 Here. Here, heel. Sit.
Good.
Good girl. Good girl. Now we can hold hands. You want to hold hands? Hold.